When I first started working with my faculty mentor as a research assistant, I felt kind of unsure. But with time, I became increasingly confident. Confident in the different areas of research, in communicating and collaborating.
You started as a first-year graduate student, and like a lot of graduate students say, it can be pretty overwhelming during the first year. They're not sure what they want to do during that first year. Dissertation work typically doesn't start until later, during the second or third year, but you were ready. I remember asking you if you were sure and suggested maybe waiting until next year, but you earnestly said no. You were ready to start.
I think it's really important that students themselves are responsible for doing the interviews. Also, we learned a lot of new information about really what to do, how to change internship experiences, so we can teach people off campus how to make internship experiences more accessible.
My mentor, Dr. Julie Hotchkissong, or rather, my annotator-in-chief, was helpful in giving me the structure I needed to proceed with my research project. She showed me a scientific approach for working with the data using a theoretical framework. It was nice to see that in action, particularly how theories apply to data organization and data analysis as well.
Dr. Braun was helpful in providing the support I need for manuscript writing, as well as with making decisions about which scientific field to pursue and post-graduation plans. He was extremely supportive. And Dr. Gormley taught me how to collect data, how to begin an interview, and also how to do manuscript writing. The three of us meet on a regular basis to gauge my progress.
Feeling comfortable interacting with the professor is definitely a big benefit. Plus, her office is right next door, so if anything related to work comes up, I can always check in with her. We have our weekly lab meeting, so during work, we take notes, and when we meet, we make sure everyone knows what's happening.
What I like about her is she takes her feedback seriously. Despite my lack of linguistic research experience, whenever I would hesitatingly offer feedback or a suggestion here and there, she would sincerely listen. I like that about her because it makes me feel valued. Even with my lack of experience, she makes me feel like my contribution to the research project was relevant.
I've become comfortable and familiar with her communication style. Dr. Gormley is really easygoing, and we truly have a good relationship.
Sometimes I'd ask my mentor if my work was progressing well. She'd say yes, but would tell me honestly if there were any mistakes.
Dr. Hotchkissong's confidence in my work helps me to continue to improve and to be motivated to learn more about what I'm doing. Plus, this project provides a lot of networking. The senior researcher for this project is based at the University of Connecticut, and we also work with a person from Holland, so I'm meeting people from different areas. We recently added a collaborator at Boston University. They have a project similar to ours, so we're collaborating with them on our project. Currently, there are four universities that work together on this whole project, and we're continuing to expand. Really, it's been beneficial for me to go into the MA program and have an opportunity to continue to work in the field after graduation. It's definitely a goal for all students entering any program to know where they're going after they graduate. This work definitely helps me with that. My goal is to continue on to the PhD program, so the work I do now will definitely apply to that.
My advice to students is to get a mentor, because that can open their eyes to what the science world is like and to possibilities in that field. Really, any field.
We really appreciate it a lot. We're glad for the research experience, not just for the sake of adding it to our resume, but also because this experience allows us to apply practical skills to future internships, which is great. Thank you.
In the beginning, when we started working and writing papers together, you would use standard layman terms or conversational language in your writing. That was your initial approach. You remember that?
Yeah, I really didn't understand scientific writing with its jargon and the need to follow APA guidelines that are commonly used in the psychology field. So when we sat down to write a paper together, she would teach me proper phrases to use. And I really learned a lot.
You remember when we went to Barnes & Noble and how we set up camp at the cafe with food, coffee, and our laptops and pounded away at the keyboard until we completed and submitted our paper? It was accepted for publication.
Yes, and it was published.
You were the second co-author of that paper. That time you hadn't even started graduate school.
Right, that's the other thing I appreciate about our mentor-mentee relationship and the experience. She's encouraged me to submit papers for publication, and that's helped to increase my list of publications and my experience. That's been invaluable.
And now, do you feel comfortable with writing?
Yes, it's still a learning process.
Yes, I'm still learning to write, even now, and improving. It's a lifelong learning process for writing.
I'm impressed that you've actually written a paper for publication. That's truly remarkable for an undergraduate student. It looks like you'll be publishing maybe 2 papers, and for an undergrad, that's a lot.
I'm really thankful for this opportunity. Not everyone gets to have this opportunity, and I'm really grateful.